What's going on, guys? Good morning. It is Tuesday again, new release day. Just a quick recap on my weekend. Friday, did a special St. Patty's Day Blues and Brews with my homeboy Schuler.
Cheers.
If you guys haven't seen that one, please go check that out. Saturday, celebrated my daughter's birthday. Turned 5 years old, had a pretty fun time, spent time with family, it was pretty cool, everything went well. But as for today, about to step on at the house, check out when your releases came out today. I know Jumanji came out today, haven't seen it, so hope I like it. Time to step on the house and see what I find. Here are the new releases, and of course, they have Jumanji and Pitch Perfect 3 along with Pitch Perfect Trilogy. But what I'm here for is Jumanji. Gonna get this one for today. Gonna keep looking around, see if they have the original. I don't believe I have that one. So gonna keep looking around and see what else I can find. Here they have Moonlight. After all this time, I finally got a chance to watching it yesterday. And I can honestly say, it was not better than La La Land. Here they have Manchester by the Sea. I sat down and watched it yesterday. It's pretty boring, I didn't even finish it. I think I barely got in 20 minutes, but maybe I'll give it another try. Maybe not, but this one was kind of dull, kind of boring. Here it is, the original Jumanji with Robin Williams. So, I'm gonna get me the original and this remake, reimagining, whatever it is. Prince, up close and personal. I think I'm finally gonna pick this one up. Here at Walmart, they put out a Jumanji backboard. And like Target still has a Justice League. All right, guys, I am home for today. Didn't get too much. I am taking a chance on this new Jumanji Welcome to the Jungle movie. I know people were going crazy online regarding the Steelbook. They thought it was a little too high to pay for a movie kind of dorky as Jumanji. $35.99 for a steelbook. I know one of my friends was saying that's ridiculous. He wasn't sure if it was worth it or not. I don't think he picked it up, but I got the DVD. Something simple, as usual. Taking a chance on this movie. I have not seen this movie, so I don't know what to expect. Looks like it's gonna be action-packed, so probably check it out later on this week and see how it is. Now, I also got the classic, the original Jumanji with Robin Williams. This is one I saw at the theater when I was a little kid with my parents. I enjoyed this one. This one was a good movie. I know my whole family enjoyed it when we went to go see it at the theater. But yeah, I'm glad I could get the original. And at Walmart, there wasn't much. So I picked up Pretty in Pink.
Been wanting to get this one for a while, so finally managed to pick it up. I always like this one. Personally, I always preferred Breakfast Club and 16 Candles over this one, but this one was more drama heavy than the other Molly Ringwald movies. But this is a good one. I like the scene where John Cryer is dancing to Otis Redding in the record store. Try a Little Tenderness. That part, that was pretty cool. Now, I also got this Prince Up Close and Personal DVD. It includes exclusive interviews. Not sure if it has concerts or concert footage, but I've always been a fan of Prince. Picked this one up for $5. Not too bad. I'll check this one out later. He was a talent that is gone too soon, but he left us all with good music and a couple movies, Purple Rain being the most popular one. But yeah, pick this one up. This concludes my Tuesday's Finds video. Kept it simple today, didn't overbuy. Didn't buy shit that I didn't need. If you guys like this brief Tuesday's Finds video, please give it a like. And to my new viewers, hit that subscribe button. Look for me on social media. The links will be in the description. And until next time, guys.